drug-resistant organisms in patients, but also possibly on healthcare workers or colonized individuals. And we also want to look at, be able to look at the environment in healthcare facilities, mainly surfaces, because they are often a source of spread of the infections. So the major aim, I mean, it's obviously to improve patient care and reduce the spread of multidrug resistant organisms. And then what organisms to detect? We have spoken about that earlier, and in the beginning we had a longer list, but what was easy to get an agreement about was that it should be detection of carbapenem resistant gram-negative bacteria. So that's, I would say, highest on the list. Then we have ESBL-producing gram-negatives, Klebsiella, Acinetobacter, but E. coli is what we had light here. And on the gram-positive side, we want to have light Clostridium difficile, and maybe also MRSA. But you can see what's bold here, it's what we have been most focused on. And then one thing that is important here is that even if you only look at initially one organism to detect, we would like to have the ability of a system to be adaptable to new organisms. So then a few words about methods in use today. I mean, we all know that culture and isolation, cultivating the bacteria and selecting media and biochemical procedures, enzyme this, enzyme that, it works very well. And culture in the presence of antibiotics, it works like a charm. And then you look on the phenotype of the bugs, and then on the genotype, we can do a PCR, and it works very well. At least I think so. So the conclusion is that what we have today, it works very well. But however, the sampling and the transportation to the laboratory, the time lap, the time to do this analysis, that's the real problem. So what we want to go to the bedside, point of care, or we want to have the detection more close to where we have the contamination. And we can look at, I put up here from the net, from one big producer of instruments. It doesn't matter what company it is, there are more. And they have marvelous machines that analyze things. And what's missing there? I would say that what's missing is this early warning, the point of care aspect, that we want to take the detection close to the patient. And we, at the same time, we want to have a minimal or even no workload on the local healthcare worker. And that's really, really a critical thing, because we cannot accept that it will be a lot of handling of sample preparation, that we suddenly move a laboratory to the clinic. That's not possible either. It has to be very, very easy to handle. And speed. I mean, real time, that's detection, that's really what we want to have. We have bacteria there, okay, we detect them now. But where the what we can stand here in time, that is a little open question, but it has to be faster than today using the central laboratory facilities. Then the thing about the continuous or high-frequent sampling. If we today talk about taking a PCR once a week, that's not acceptable. We have to have a more frequent sampling. Ideal, we would like to detect the bugs as soon as they exist. But somewhere we have to find a reasonable frequency of sampling. And here I want you to dazzle us, to come up with something that is better than we would think would be possible. And then, of course, in the end, we would also want to have a connectivity to a healthcare data handling systems. If you go over to the quick tests, I mean, there are tests on the market. You can detect MRSA from a colony in 5 minutes. And there I said the word colony. In that case, you have to cultivate it first. And that's not acceptable. Here, the detection is quick, relatively easy, but you have to culture first. And I mentioned earlier Clostridium, and there are lateral flow devices that detect it in 30 minutes also. And I mean, there are lots of things that work, but they all require various degree of sample handling, also often culturing, a lot of manual work, and these more simple devices, I mean, they don't have any automatic connection to a data handling system either. And if you look at surfaces in the environment, you don't have any automatic alarms. If you look at more new developments on the, we can start with, you can say, the genotypic side. When you have ways to analyze the whole, to sequence the genome of our organism very, very quickly today. But I mean, let's not overdo it here. That's not really reasonable. And hybridization assays, you can get enormous amounts of information here, but for this you need a real lab. You will have to have expensive equipment. It has come, there are developments of more easy and quick and possibly more patient close analysis that are often based on isothermal amplification of DNA. With that you can do slightly more simple design of the instrumentation for it. But in general you can say that all these things, they have to have a sample preparation. Either you do it outside the device or the device do it for you. And then the device will of course become more complicated. And still the continuous or high frequency measurements, it's still not here as I see it. Then a few words on another side, on the more phenotypic side. And if you look at the detection of of enzymes breaking down antibiotics, there are systems suggested that look at the hydrolysis hydrolytic products of beta lactamases are detected either by mass spectrometry or that sort of way, or that you use fluorescent derivatives of the antibiotics that turn fluorescent up on cleavage with the beta lactamase. And people are working with this, quite many people, and that might be a more easy way to go, but I'm not here to give suggestions. So rounding up here, how to get beyond state of the art. It's a little repetition here. But we have to come more to the point of care for the detection of multidrug resistant organism. We want to detect it on patients, maybe also healthcare workers and colonized individuals. And we want to detect these bugs also on surface in the environment in the hospital. And some of the common demands, you heard a lot of demands in the morning, but I just mentioned some that I find to be really key here, that it should be fast and it should be continuous or with a high frequency. And that give quite strong set of limitations on the device. And even worse, minimum labor input, because we cannot afford to have the healthcare workers working with the instrumentation instead of the patients. There will not be economical space for that. And we would like to have it possible with integration with the healthcare data communication system. And of course, cost efficient. It comes together there. And sensitivity and specificity, as good as the clinical bacteriological lab. And that's a question for discussions, I think. That was all. And in 2 minutes, my taxi is here.